13 laps away of refueling. So they're going to make another pit stop. So now we're back in action here at Kansas Speedway after a brief intermission. It didn't last long. Now they're starting with Suarez. He's running in 15th. He won't be back with that team next season. He'll be in the new team, and he might be creating his own team as well. He won't be back with TBR. Somebody else might be riding that car next season. In my career mode, he is in the playoffs as well, too. We're 3.4 seconds ahead of Truex. Kyle Busch is third, and we're ready for some tires again. And my teammate, Cole Custer, is now running in 14th. He's about to go the lap down. We're 33 laps into stage two, and it looks like we're ready for some tires on this thing. Not a good race for Eric Jones. That's why he's going to be leaving that team next season. Remember, I'm going to be going to that 20 car next season. Running alongside with Justin Haley. Whoa, man, and Jimmy Johnson almost spun me out. But I saved it right there. That was a nice save. I avoided disaster there. That would have been a DNF right there, too. Yeah, my tires are wearing out. And it looks like it's going to wear out even more after that spin. Well, it looks like Chad Beecham is the slowest car in the field. He's about to go another lap down. We only got 10% of the tire wear on them with 6 laps away of fueling. Well, we have 4 laps away of making a pit stop. We're pulling away from 4.7 seconds now ahead of Truex. Trying to save these tires as much as we can. And now Brian Newman is now going to be putting a lap down. the next lap, we're going to be pitting. Yeah, we're going to pit on the next lap. Next time around, we have to pit. So we don't make contact with any other cars because we don't want that right front tire blowing out. There's only 2% of these tires left, and we're certainly going to make a pit stop. And we barely made it on time. So we're going to make a pit stop here on this lap. Now we're going to come in for the pit. Going to put a full tank of fuel in 4 tires. Everybody else has to pit too. It's a good pit stop. There's everybody else coming into the pit. And also Martin Truex is in the pits too. Well, we drop into P3. Martin Truex now gets out of the pit. Let's see what happens here. Let's see how many seconds ahead I'm going to be ahead of Martin Truex as he now gets out of the pit now. We were about 4.2 seconds ahead, and it's going to be the same scenario. Well, we're a little bit faster than this Jimmy Johnson going into the pits, and Truex, man, we took a 5.3 second advantage. I mean, that was a pretty good pit stop for us here at in this latter part of the stage with 22 laps remaining here in stage 2. Running side by side against Chris Buescher. Careful. 19 laps remaining here in stage 2. 4.9 seconds ahead of Truex. Kevin Harvick now moved up into P4. After that pit stop, he had a faster pit stop, and he's now in P4, getting around Kyle Busch. going to bunch up the field again. We had a 5.4 second lead over Martin Truex, and now the field's going to be bunched up again. Yeah, it looks like somebody's got a blown motor up ahead. It looks like that's Alex Bowman in the Valvoline car. Well, Alex Bowman could be out of the race here at Kansas. What a tough race for the Hendrick Motorsports car. Well, he's still out there. We only have two cars out of the race. It's Ty Dillon and Ryan Preece. We're three car lengths ahead of Kyle Busch, who's now running in P2. And William Byron is having an awesome race here so far here in Kansas. And Denny Hamlin is now back in the thick of things. He's now running in P5. He gets around his teammate, Martin Truex Jr., for P4. We have 10 laps remaining here in stage two. I think we're already after 160 of 267 laps, so this race is almost over. And then the final stage, we could be in the final 100 laps of this race. We've already passed halfway here in Kansas Speedway. Four car lengths ahead of Kyle Busch. And we're pulling away from Kyle Busch as he bunches up into the field. Look at this, competitive racing over there. Kevin Harvick is on the move. He's now into P3. Trying to be on the outside against Kyle Busch. And alongside of Martin Truex, he still has a good car too. William Byron now drops to fifth. Hour and 30 minutes into the race, and we also have that 5-minute intermission that we had to make a phone call. And for YouTube subscribers, I'm going to have to put this in two parts after I had that phone call. Look at this, four car length now, and here's Martin Truex Jr. again. Here we go. Here we go again. He's on the move. Remember, he is the pole sitter here in the Kansas Speedway, and that's why he has still got a fast race car. another blown motor. That looks to be David Reagan in the 36 car, and now he is going to be out of the race. What a tough race for David Reagan in the front row motorsport. So that would be the third retirement of the race. Already three retirements so far with blown motors. With Ryan Preece and Ty Dillon, both having blown motors, and now the next victim to have blown motors, David Reagan. I'm going to be holding him, and it's the final lap here in the stage two, and I'm going to be holding off Arn Short for five car lengths. He's closing in. He's getting drafting help from my teammate Kevin Harvick for third, and I'm going to hold on to for a stage two win here in Kansas. So I will get a stage two win at the Kansas Speedway. Here we go. That was a nice job in the second stage. So now, Martin Truex won stage one, I win stage two. And we have 107 laps remaining here at the Kansas Speedway. And everybody's going to be pinning on this lap. Chase Elliott still runs in the top 10, and Ryan Newman will be back on the lead lap. So with 107 laps remaining, it is now total darkness here at Kansas Speedway. Here we go, getting us back into the restart. And here's the restart with 104 laps remaining here in the Digital Alley 400. So the final stage is 104 laps to determine who is going to win the Digital Alley 400. This race is past halfway. We are after 164 of 267 laps. Kevin Harvick is now getting a run. He's trying to take the lead away from me. Both of the Stewart Haas cars going at it. Side-by-side racing here in Kansas Speedway in the final 100 laps to go here in Kansas. Thank you. So they're running competitively side by side. I get a little bit too high there. Now I'm getting passed by my teammate Kevin Harvick and Martin Truex. Man, this is great competitive racing. If we lose the toe end and everything, we've seen a lot of lead changes so far here in the Digital Alley 400. We're 96 laps remaining here to finish the race here at the Digital Alley 400 at Kansas Speedway, and Truex Jr. is now second. Man, and four cars are only about three car lengths ahead. This is intense racing so far here for the lead here in Kansas. And what a great job for Kevin Harvick. He has got a superb race car tonight here at Kansas Speedway. And we're running along for the lead side by side. We're having a lot of fun out there. As long as I don't make contact with my teammate, and we can make it on two more pit stops. And the pit stop situation is on lap 80. We have 47 laps until we pit, so we're going to make it on one more stop. Running alongside with Martin Truex Jr., he's still not giving up a 5-2. I might think about letting Kevin Harvick win this race, because even though I won so much in my career mode, I want to let somebody else try to make it to the playoffs. Yeah, Truex, Harvick, Kyle Busch has already won a race, William Byron. And Daniel Suarez, remember, he did win a race, so he's running in the top 15, and that's what he needs to do. And now we got traffic coming up ahead. Look, we are seesawing battle here for the lead. Me and Martin Truex Jr. Just giving him the space, but I don't want to make contact with him. He has a great race car. No doubt about it. Look at this. He is running so competitively. if people are going to watch this, you're not going to get this tired. You're going to see a lot of action here at Kansas Speedway. Look at these slingshot move again and back to the lead. And Kyle Busch is involved in this. This has been a four-car battle for the lead here at Kansas. This is an incredible, intense racing. Now here's the traffic coming along. Just backing out of the throttle a little bit. Now I get around in between Gong and Gage. Well, the only one mistake that we had was hitting a wall going into turn one while I was looking around to see if Ty Dillon was out of the race, and he was. But for most of all, I've been running superb out there, and this has been intense racing so far, side by side, after those caution flags. But now I'm beginning to pull away from Martin Truex Jr. now that the field is spreading out a little bit. It's a close call right there from Dallin Nemechek. Bobby Carter running in 28. Johnson from 27. They're going on another lap down. Jimmy Johnson from 26. Well, with 32 laps remaining here, 76, our last pit stop is going to be with 49 laps remaining. So that'll be our final pit stop of the day here in Kansas if we stay under green. We're already past 79 laps remaining, so that means now we can make it on fuel all the way to the end of this race. We're 9 car lengths ahead of Martin Truex. Already about a second now ahead of Martin Truex. Kyle Busch is third. Kevin Harvick fourth, and William Byron having a sensational run in the 24 Hendrick car, who runs from P5. With 78 laps remaining. Laps are winding down quickly here as we go so fast here at this 1.5 mile oval here in Kansas. The next race, episode number 15, will be at the long 2 mile track at Michigan International Speedway. Next race for the trucks will be the second race at Texas. Xfinity will also be at Michigan as well. And then right after Michigan will be the second road course race, but the first one for the Cup Series as they go to Sonoma Raceway. Alex Bowman still running in P21 right now, running alongside with Quinn Hoff and Max Benedetto. Quinn Hoff is running in 20th, Benedetto is in 19th. Now, what an incredible job from Matty D. He still was so close to getting his first ever career win, but fell short. But Kurt Busch won that Las Vegas race in the cone track. And we're starting to pull away now from Martin Truex Jr., running in 1.3 seconds ahead of Truex. My teammate Kevin Harvick is still got a shot at it in P3. Kyle Busch is fourth. William Byron has had an incredible race so far, running in P5. He's still holding on to it. There's Truex right there, and I believe that's Harvick right there, well behind. Thank you. and about three laps, we would be passing the 200 lap mark. We're an hour and 53 minutes into the race. Actually, we're an hour and 48 minutes into the race because we took that 5-minute intermission during our phone call. We put another lap on Tyler Reddick, who was running in P18. Torres is still running in the top 20. He's now running in P17. And that's going to be a caution flag with 69 laps to go. And that is going to be our final pit stop of the day. The caution comes out. I think that was 60 laps. I think we're going to have to do one more stop. Yeah, because it says 60 laps, so we're going to be about 8 laps short of fuel. We have 5 laps short, so that means we have to make it maybe a fuel only in the end of the thing. There's our fourth car out of the race. So let's see who is the latest retiree after this one. It looks like he crashed his car. We're 5 laps short of fuel, so we're going to have to make another one more stop. Caution came at a bad time right now after that one. It looks like it's Joey Gase in the 51 car that's out of the race. Well, he wasn't doing good anyway. And here comes Truex. He's just trying to pass on the inside to the battle for the lead. Byron is now in third. Ron Truex Jr. is getting a run this time. I'm only about 2 car lengths behind him, running at equal speed so far. Man, I'm slightly trying to get around them.
Yeah.
And now Kevin Harvick, my teammate, is now close in the front of the leaders after running that dirty air, and we're still running with, against each other, me and Martin Truex Jr. Now Kevin Harvick is going to give me a little bit of a draft to pull right on into the lead. And indeed I do. Now that's a nice push by my teammate Kevin Harvick. Doing a lot of great teamwork to try to beat out the Joe Gibbs. Past the 2 hour mark already, and we're still 56 laps away of finishing the Digital Alley 400. And Kevin Harvick is still slingshotting all over me right now for the lead. Yeah, even though we both run the same identical cars, you know, there's the Mobile 1 car, and I'm driving the Blue Zap car. And I drop in the P3. Look at this, the three-car freight train for the lead. Oh, he slowed down a little bit. He had to check up a little bit on my teammate, Kevin Harvick. Man, who is going to win this race at the end? Is it going to be me, my teammate Harvick, or the Truex? And I go low into that apron, and I get back into it again. It's been awesome racing so far. Well, this episode is going to have a lot of people's attention waiting here, and we're still battling for this lead in the end of the race. I'm running alongside with my teammate, Kevin Harvick. He is giving me all the work that he needs. And we still got the ferocious Truex Jr. We're 53 laps away from the Digital Alley 400. Anybody can win this race in the top three. Kyle Busch is still running in fourth, and William Byron is not far behind. As we're running against each other, I think those guys are going to be closing in on us if we keep this up. 51 laps remaining here to end this race here in the Digital Alley 400. And it's been a three-way car battle, a triple threat battle for the lead. And Martin Truex Jr. is still not going to give up. He is not going to give up a fight. He wants that win. And he's running alongside against me. And there's my teammate, Kevin Harvick, running in third. Looking for any opportunity to either choose me as my draft partner or go around Truex. Oh, a little bit of a checkup there. I went too close to the car. I'm going to have to let my teammate Harvick go and regroup again. Now we're getting into lap traffic. Here comes the back markers. And the first back marker is, Chad Beecham. Still the slowest car in the field. He's running at 36. Now we have three cars out of the race. Oh, that's Joey Gase in the 35 car. So that wasn't Joey Gase that was out of the race. He's still out there. I had to slow down a little bit because I wanted not to make contact with Joey Gay. I think that was probably, is Bobby Carter still out there? Well, I retained the lead after getting back by that traffic, but look at Truex, he's still side by side running against me. Kevin Harvick is still there. If we do get a caution, we are going to make that final round of pit stop. Look at this, three wide, Stewart Haas racing style, and we both take over Martin Truex Jr. See if we can try to take over Timothy Hill. I got to be careful. There's Kevin Harvick. He is still leading this race. It's incredible racing here in Kansas Speedway. I could have ever thought that we were going to have a triple threat battle for the win here at the Ditto Alley 400. 46 laps to go. And here we have Ross Chastain and Darrell Wallace. There's several laps down now. Let's see if we can get around those guys. And I took the advantage over there, and I used both of those lap cars, and now they're slowing down. Harvick's trying to look to get by one of the lap cars. We're about 38 laps away. We're still short on fuel. I think we'll take fuel only and two tires on the last pit stop. We're going to take right side tires. The left side tires look fine. Eight car lengths advantage over Martin Truex Jr. and Kevin Harvick. I'm pulling away from them as they now finally they get through traffic. Martin Truex Jr. still about eight car lengths ahead of them. We have 41 laps remaining here in the Ditto Alley 400 here at Kansas Speedway in the night race. You're watching episode number 14. We're 2 hours, 8 minutes into the race. Still a competitive race so far between Truex and Harvick. And now William Byron and Kyle Busch is now pulled away far out now. All they need right now is a caution if they want to have their last chance of winning this race. now 9 laps short of fuel, but we can pit within 9 laps to go. We can short pit and then just put 3 tires in the car. A caution will change everything, and then we can just change all 4 tires and then short pit and then short fuel. Harvick is now closing in on Truex Jr., but 1.6, 1.1 seconds, and I'm pulling away from Truex just a little bit. My car is working now very well, and we have 25 laps away of refueling. We have about 34 laps to go. So we used up about 11 laps of fuel, so we'll be pitting within 11 laps to go. As I now put another lap on Matty G. 1.1 seconds ahead of Martin Truex Jr. My car is running very well here in Kansas. Ran a P9 here last season, but this season I am doing much better. Without the assist, I had it with the assist last season, but without the assist, it is helping my car go a lot more faster than it usually is. Even though I've been on the loose side in turns 1 and 2, turns 3 and 4 has been okay. I've been running very good in turns 3 and 4. 29 laps remaining here in the Digital Alley 400. 29 laps away from winning another unprecedented NASCAR Cup Series at a close-action race. And hopefully the caution doesn't come out. If we stay in like this, we're on our way to victory here at America's Heartland in Kansas. Now pulling away from Martin Truex, already 2 seconds ahead of him. My teammate Kevin Harvick is about six car lengths behind Martin Truex for P2. He's closing in on Martin Truex Jr. We have 28 laps remaining. We're 18 laps away of pitting. We're going to be pitting within 10 laps to go. We'll just short fuel and then let's see how the tires are. We're going to have to maybe change all four tires on this car. I had to slow down a little bit because I had to get around Ross Chastain. It's Tyler Reddick running in 18th. He's been in the top 20 throughout this race. Still doing a good job in that. Richard Solvik's car, number 8. Not a good race for Ryan Blaney. And not a good race for Bubba Wallace. He can't wait to get out of that petty ride and go to the MJ Hamlin Motorsports ride. And he's really going to love that team. He's gonna really going to love being the Air Jordan of racing. We can't wait to see them in NASCAR 21 game, too. Ryan Blaney ranked 17, not having a good day. Dennis Suarez is back in the thick of things. He's running in 16th. He's trying to get all the points he can to stay in for that top 30 to make it to the playoffs. He's got about maybe 13 races to go. Remember, we're 13 races away from the NASCAR playoffs. Now we got 25 laps to go. John Nemechek in 29th, not having a good race. Ricky Stenhouse goes around him in 28th spot. He's several laps down. The tires are chewing up pretty good, but they won't chew up in the end of the race. We're 14 laps until we pit. So we're going to be pitting within 10 laps to go. We're 24 laps remaining. So this is going to be a 10-lap shootout to the finish. Let's make sure we make a good, clean pit stop and short fuel. If the caution comes out, that will go out the window, and then it will be competitive racing at the end. There's Amarola. He's running in 13th place. Still doing a good job out there. He's trying to battle for 14th with Matt Kenseth. Get a little bit on the loose side. I don't want to put Kenseth in the wall. And that's my teammate right there, Eric Amarola, running in P13. And now he goes 2 laps down. And my tires are wearing down. And it's Cole Custer running in 14th. Yeah, me and Harvick are doing well, but Cole Custer and Eric Amarola are running 13th and 14th. They've been in the top 15 throughout the races, so they're still running good. They sound a bit of a struggle here in Kansas. And a very bad performance race for Eric Jones. I'll be very glad when I go in that car next season for my second season of my NASCAR D5 career mode. see Bobby Carter out there. I think he was the last car that was out of the race. Yeah, so he was the next victim that was out of the race, so it's not great for him. Eight laps away from making our final pit stop of the day. And it's going to be a 10-lap shootout to the finish. We now get around this in Haley. We're now about, 3.7 seconds now ahead of Martin Truex. Harvick is still standing in third. Let's hope we don't speed on pit road, or otherwise we lose this race. Man, nice handling corner going into turns 1 and 2 here in Kansas. The car's been running very well. It's a very fast race here. You know, in the second race in the NASCAR playoffs, when we were turning back to Kansas during the daytime race. And the caution is out. And we see a spinner, and that's Chase Elliott in the number 9 car who was running in the top 10. He spins out right into the grass. And he brings out the caution, and now it is going to be intense racing at the end of this thing. I don't know who's going to win it, and I was right. That was Bobby Carter. That was the last car that was out of the race on the previous caution. So now we're going to put fuel, I don't want to put 20 laps of fuel. I'll put maybe 35 laps of fuel, and most certainly we're going to put 4 tires in the car. And that's going to drop me into P11. Well, I just want to make sure that I have a lot of fuel in the car because I don't want to eat it up and then run out of fuel by then. And I put 4 tires on it, so I have fresh tires throughout this race. So now fuel miles is out of the window, and now it is time to win this race. We've got into P11. And now let's see if I can try to pass these cars. Here is Chris Buescher, who is having a sensational race here at the end. He's now running in P9 in the Ross Fenway number 17 car. I get around him. Remember, I have the fresher tires. I got the fresher tires on this car. And what a good job for Ryan Newman. He has been running in the top 10 as well. We're 13 laps away. Look at this, 3 wide going into turns 1 and 2. I move up into P5. I go around the outside of Ryan Newman. He's doing a good job at the end. I think he took the 4 tires as well. And now I'm running with the leaders. Here's William Byron running in third. There's Kevin Harvick second. They're all trying to get around the Martin Truex Jr. This is a battle for the win here in the Digital Alley 400 with 12 laps to go. And I'm now running alongside with the leaders. Look at this. The 3 wide going into turn 2. Here is me and Kevin Harvick. We're running second and third right now. We're trying to catch the leader. And here comes Truex. And I take the lead once again with 11 laps to go. We have 5 cars out of the race. The most recent caution, that was Chase Elliott. He's DNF. What a tough race for the Hendrick Motorsports car, Chase Elliott. And I'm pulling away from Martin Truex Jr. I got those 4 fresh tires in this car. And here comes Martin Truex Jr. closing in. Next time around, it's 10 laps to go here in the Digital Alley 400 in Kansas. Hours and 24 minutes into the race. This is going to be a 10-lap shootout. We have 10 laps remaining here in Kansas. 4-car length lead over my teammate Kevin Harvick. Kevin Harvick is now in P2. We're 1-2 here for the Stewart Haas Racing. Man, I'm getting good speed out of this car. I'm pulling away. I'm so glad I took these 4 fresh tires. I think some of the drivers took 2 tires. That gave me an advantage. And then, look at this, it's working. This advantage is working. I took 2 tires, and we might be on our way. 1-2 finish. We have 9 laps remaining. I'm pulling away to these guys because, remember, I took 4 tires. I got four fresh rubbers on this car. Man, these four tires are making a difference. 8 laps to go here in Kansas Speedway. 1-2 is Stewart Haas Racing, me and Kevin Harvick. This was definitely the key moment of the race right here. Taking four tires, dropping from P11, and then racing competitively. I think Truex and everybody else took two tires, but I decided to change all four tires and short fuel. seconds ahead. We have had 9 cautions so far in this race. 5 cars are out of the race. Yeah, I don't think those 2 tires are helping. They should have changed 4 tires, and Truex Jr. is now going back into P2, 6 laps to go, but I don't think they're going to catch me because I took the 4 tires. With 6 laps to go, I'm on my way of winning my 12th race of the season. It's not going to give up on that P2 spot. He's still trying to battle along with Martin Truex Jr., but Truex Jr. still wants to stay there. I'm keeping an eye on those guys right there, and Harvick is still trying to get stay in P2 so we can have a 1-2 finish here in Kansas. Man, I'm the fastest car on the track, and look at all the back marker cars. We're already flying here in Kansas Speedway. And already, in the last 8 laps of the race, we're already got through the lap traffic because everybody else is taking 2 tires. We're still pulling away from our teammate, Kevin Harvick. And the caution is out. Oh, my goodness. And now that lead is going to be wiped away. And me and Kevin Harvick are going to run side by side. We are going overtime, and this is the 3rd time this season we're going overtime. Here at Kansas Speedway, the previous race at Charlotte, we went overtime, and I don't think we went overtime on that one. But we are going overtime, and we're going to stay out there. We still have 23 laps of fuel remaining. Let's see who's going to win this race. This is overtime right now. We're already well past 267 laps. Hope we can get a good restart. Kevin Harvick is running alongside me. Look at this. He's on the outside. This is going to be green-white checker. Now you got the advantage with these fresh tires. Oh, I ran a little bit too high going in there. Here comes Truex. He's coming in and closing in on me for the lead. This is the battle. Next time around, it's the white flag. 1 more lap to go. I'm getting a little bit too high. Here comes Truex. He is now running in third. Kevin Harvick drops the 4th. White flag. 1 more lap to go here in the Digital Alley 400 in Kansas. Man, I'm still pulling away. I still got that advantage, that fresh tires. Coming around the backstretch for 1 last time here in Kansas in the final turns 3 and 4. And I am going to do it here in America's Heartland at Kansas Speedway. And I'm going to win the Digital Alley 400. What a race. What an intense race here. And they win the Digital Alley 400. my 12th race of the season, and I always thought, would have thought that I could make promises to win at Kansas Speedway. What an excellent job by the team, and an excellent job in the final pit stop, going for the four tires instead of going to two tires. If I went with that, I could have lost this race, and Truex Jr. would have been the winner. What an awesome job by the Stewart Haas Racing team, and they gave me a great car and everything. It was in competitive racing style here in Kansas Speedway, and it's a very remarkable win here in Kansas. Hey, let's play some slots in the Hollywood Casino over there. Yeah, that's the Hollywood Casino on turn two. Yeah, we're going to burn it up here at Kansas Speedway. With our 12th, I think this is pretty much our 12th, 11th win of the season here. This is episode number 14, yeah, 12th win of the season. Here we go. And there's plenty of room to do donuts here at Kansas Speedway, no question about that. Let's burn a little paint rubber here at the Kansas Speedway logo here. Man, what a win here in Kansas, and what competitive racing this was here in Kansas. Yeah, give a little kiss on the wall here in our Kansas Speedway logo. Give it one last burnout. What an impressive job by the Stewart Haas Racing team this year. All right, that's going to be enough for burnout for now. What a great race here at Kansas Speedway. And we are superbly going to look at the replays of this race. Awesome job by this team. Here's the beginning of the race. Look at the intense racing. And this was all throughout this race, battling out with Martin Truex Jr., Kevin Harvick. Wow. It was a triple threat battle and a quadruple battle for a little bit, but then we were there at the end, me, Truex, and Harvick. And Harvick had a great car today. He needed this run, too. I don't know how many times I stick the lead in this thing. That was during the green flag pit stops on lap 137. And then I won the stage two. Truex won stage one. And then here's the final lap of the race. It took us 269 laps to win here at Kansas Speedway. And there's the checkered flag. beautiful performance and a great job, and that's the third time I won on overtime. So we win the race. Bryce Jr. did win stage two. He'll give it a little bit of points. Kyle Busch, third. William Byron, fourth. And I don't know what happened to Kevin Harvick. He was running so competitively in the top three throughout the race and drops into the top five. Good job for Keselowski. He finishes in sixth. Danny Hamlin finishes in seventh. And a great job for Chris Buescher. Running in the top ten today. He gets a top ten car and finishes in P8. Great job by the Ralph Spinway guys. And Kurt Busch, our Las Vegas winner in real life, finishes in ninth. Joey Logano rounds out the top ten. And Brian Newman drops into 11th. And Eric Amarola finishes in 12th. Well, it's the last car in the lead lap. They see the rest of the field. Good job to Daniel Suarez. He's 16. And not a bad spot for 20 for Quinn Hoff in the double zero car. Not a good race for Christopher Bell. There were two of the slowest Joe Gibbs cars. Christopher Bell and Eric Jones had an awful race. Austin Dillon had an awful race. Good improvement for Justin Hanley, P24. And not a good race for Jimmy Johnson. Dismal, 25th place. And a bad finish for Eric Jones. And here's some of the others that were out of the race. Man, what a tough race for Chase Elliott. He had a top 10 car. He was running as high as 7th, and then he dropped out of the race. And Bobby Carter was out. So was David Reagan, Ty Dillon, and then very early in the race, Ryan Preece. Let's take a look at our early. We get 318, 884 of winning the Digital Alley 400. And we're going to take a look at the standings now. That was my 12th win of the season, and I have 77 playoff points, a commanding lead in the point standing over Kyle Busch. Remember, the only three drivers that won is me, 12 wins, Ryan Blaney has the win, and Daniel Suarez, who won in Talladega. And running in the top 16 right now, and Chase Elliott better be careful, because Chris Buescher is now tied with Chase Elliott in that wild card spot in the top 16. But I think Brian Newman is the wild card, because remember, Daniel Suarez is in 23rd, and he is in the playoffs. But we'll take a look at it after we go to Winner's Circle and wrap it up here for episode number 14 at Kansas Speedway. What an impressive win. That's a nice looking trophy there. Wonder what kind of trophy shape is that? Man, good job by the team. And the Blue Jet car that ran flawlessly, competitively in the front of the pack throughout this race. And running competitively with Truex and Harvick and Kyle Busch for quite some time. Impressive job by the Stewart Haas Racing team. Well, that will wrap it up here, and we will do Formula One racing in about maybe around high noon. So we'll do Formula One. That will be episode number 55 in the Austrian Grand Prix. We're driving a very special livery paint scheme for that Formula One Austrian Grand Prix, which will be the Races 1 rainbow paint scheme that is black on one side and white on the other with the rainbow colors on the side. And it's going to perform pretty cool here at the... when we race the Austrian Grand Prix for Formula One. Until then, on behalf of Blue Jeff, Digital Alley, also Rush Truck Centers, and also American Ethanol here at America's Heartland Kansas Speedway, thank you so much for watching an intense and competitive racing here at Kansas Speedway. And it was a great win here in the Digital Alley 400. And racing with these guys was absolutely remarkable. We had a lot of fun out there. So until then, we'll see you about an hour and 15 minutes for running of the Austrian Grand Prix. Thank you for watching, and goodbye, everyone, for now.